and welcome to Night Out Tonight. And tonight on Night Out, we're going to get our intellectual dose because we've managed to book some time with Chetan Bhagat. And trust me, that is not a very easy thing because he's all set to create a revolution. And my mind definitely needs a revolution.
You're talking about intellectual. Who are you talking about? Because I don't
see anybody intellectual. You're definitely intellectual compared to me. So yeah, it's all about perspective.
It's a relative, really.
It's a relative thing, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's lovely to be in Night Out, and it's I'm glad that people are excited about a book. I mean, it is the name is Revolution 2020, but as some are saying, it's going to cause a revolution. Let's hope he does. And it was with gorgeous Sonam Kapoor here. We launched the book. Be fantastic.
Absolutely. So yes, we have a little bit more with Sonam also coming up. She's a woman who's created a revolution on screen and of course in the fashion world as well. And obviously he says that he's going to create a revolution. And the title of the book also, the subtitle is Love, Corruption and Ambition. Now that sounds like a
which
Bollywood...
Which one are you most interested in between love, corruption and ambition?
Corruption. And ambition and love. Okay, actually all three. The book could have been written for me.
Those are the things the youth is most cares about right now. Yeah. I mean, I have been always try to capture the mood of the nation. Mm-hmm. And I thought, of course, love and ambition is usually the, your career, your love life is what youth cares about. But certainly corruption has become a big issue. Absolutely. And I've been writing about it in columns. So I thought, let me make a nice love story with corruption in the backdrop. Yeah. So it was difficult, but it's turned out okay, I think.
Now, this already sounds like it's going to be a Bollywood film. Love, corruption and ambition. What else do you really need? So have there already been talks with you or anything like that?
Yeah, there are some. I mean, you know, like they say, kahani puri filmy hai.
Absolutely. That's what we expect from
you. It's a good filmy. You know, it's filmy, but it's nice filmy. And there are some producers who
we love filmy here at Night Out.
Of course we do. I mean, the whole country loves filmy. Why should we? It's filmy, but we like filmy, you know. So I think, but there are a few houses who asked me for the rights to make a movie. So I said, it may be a good idea to read the book first.
That would be a good idea, we think.
The thing is, like, they are, de do basam hai. So, but, you know, we're going to do something later. But right now, the focus is to make sure people read. People are spoiled. They're watching too many movies. Please, India, it's time to read.
Absolutely. And on a very serious note, I have to agree with that. And coming back to the woman who's going to be a big, big part of this evening, Sonam Kapoor. Now, this seems to be a rather unusual sort of friendship, like you and Sonam Kapoor. So how did this friendship really develop?
Well, there are many. Why is it so unusual? Well, she's a, she's a Punjabi.
She's
a Punjabi. I'm Punjabi. So we, you know, ek hi zile ke hain. And she's, if you notice her bio on Twitter, where Twitter only allows you a one-line bio.
Eat and read.
Yeah. And eat, you can see me. I've been eating and, you know, I write. So eat and write and eat and read. Mm-hmm. So it's a natural fit.
Promised you that we would have Sonam Kapoor, the woman who creates quite a revolution on screen and of course with her fashion choices. And of course she's doing that today as well because she's actually only Sonam Kapoor would do this. She matched her outfit to Chetan's book cover, right?
Yes, I did. I did. I did that. I just thought it was cool that his book was pink and white. Absolutely. And usually I'm not known as a very girly dresser. So I was like, I might as well be a little girly. And I wore this.
What is it about Chetan that inspires you?
I think we are we connect on the fact that we have foot in the mouth disease.
I think that's very important bonding point.
And not only that, he writes books. And I like that. I want to make friends who write and who are intelligent. And he's also changed the face of reading in our country because that people have stopped reading. And you know, people might say whatever they want to say about his books, but they're easy to read. Yeah. They do say something. There's a relevant point in them. And they have a lot of culture in it, especially Indian culture. So I enjoy it. I enjoy it.
I mean, obviously, a lot of Chetan's books have been converted to films as well. Yeah. Which one do you feel was the most justice to his book?
Really? I think it was Three Idiots. I know there's a lot of controversy surrounding it, but that was actually very, very true to the book. So I think the story itself was very specific. And it was the book, the essence of those characters were in the book, and I really, really loved it. Another book which I think would make a beautiful film is Two States, but obviously there's been a lot of speculation about it.
And you're someone who obviously knows something about, you know, book to film adaptations, which we've seen with Aisha as well. Is it true that you guys were planning to make an adaptation of Pride and Prejudice also, and is there any development on that?
We weren't ever going to make Pride and Prejudice. You know, I'm a little bit of a snob when it comes to books. I think there are very few books that have been adapted beautifully into movies. I think one of the few ones are Godfather and maybe to a certain extent Gone with the Wind or something like that. But I don't think there are very many movies that are very that are true,
do justice just, to the book.
Yeah, I know. Maybe I know it's just mean. Me. Like, so for me to do that, I really need to believe in the script and really need to believe in the story. And Pride and Prejudice has been ruined so many times that I feel the only film that I think came close to making a Jane Austen film, which I think was Sense and Sensibility.
Yeah,
I think definitely. It was so beautifully played and so beautifully, you know, acted out. And right now, Jane Eyre, which has come out, which is beautiful.
Really nice. Yeah. I really do like that a bit.
NDTV's cricket app. Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.